Welcome. Now we'll discuss a course on an introduction to nuclear power plant. Objectives of this course are to discuss basic theory of nuclear energy, components of nuclear power plant and components of reactor, types of nuclear reactors and nuclear power plant, and to disposal of waste of nuclear power plants. After studying this course, the student will be understood the basic theory of nuclear energy, components of nuclear power plant and components of reactor. The student will be understood types of reactors, types of power plant and disposal of waste of nuclear power plants. In this course, following topics will be covered. First is introduction, then basic theory of nuclear energy. Next is elements of nuclear power plant. Then the topic covered will be nuclear reactor and their types. Types of nuclear power plants, selection of site for nuclear power plant, and the last point to be covered will be disposal of nuclear waste. First is introduction of nuclear power plant. Nuclear power plant installation in India is 6.7 gigawatt, which is about 2% of total installed capacity of India. In world also, the nuclear power plant installation scenario is comparatively less than the other power plant. Nuclear Power Corporation is the agency which monitor the nuclear power plant installation and operation in India. Similarly, in various countries, there are agencies which monitors installation and operation of nuclear power plant. Now we'll discuss theory about the nuclear power plant. First, we'll discuss structure of the atom. Atom is composed of proton, neutrons and electrons. Protons and neutrons together form a positively charged nucleus of atom, so also called as nucleons. Protons are positively charged and electrons are negatively charged, and there is no charge for neutron. Electric charge is equal for proton and electron. There are two terms related to atom: atomic number denoted by J and mass number denoted by A. Atomic number indicate number of protons present in the atom, and mass number indicate the sum of numbers of protons and neutrons present in the atom. Typically, elements are represented symbolically like this or by second method, in which X is the component or element and Z is atomic number, which indicate number of protons, and A indicate mass number, which is sum of proton and neutron. Typically, radius of nucleus of atom is equal to 10⁻⁶ meter, and radius of atom is equal to 10⁻⁻⁶ meter. Here, structure of typical helium atom is shown, in which there are four protons and there are two proton and two neutron and together form a nucleus having four nucleons, and there are two electrons which are orbiting around the nucleus, and the helium is symbolically written like this. 2 is atomic number, means number of proton, and 4 is mass number, which is addition of proton and neutron. Mass of proton MP equal to 1.007277 atomic mass unit, which is equal to 1.673 × 10⁻²⁷ kg. Mass of electron Me equal to 0.0005486 amu, which is equal to 9.109 × 10⁻³⁰ kg. Mass of neutron Mn equal to 1.008665 atomic mass unit, which is equal to 1.674 × 10⁻²⁷ kg. Amu is atomic mass unit. Now we have these three elements, hydrogen, deuterium, helium. In first two, atomic mass is same. For hydrogen, atomic number is 1, and for deuterium, atomic number is 1. But mass number for hydrogen is 1 because there is no neutron. And in deuterium, mass number is 2, means there is 1 proton and 1 neutron. And in first two element, atomic number are same, but mass number are different, and these two are called as isotope. Another element is helium, which can be written like this, where atomic number is 2 and mass number is 4, and atomic number is different from these two. So first two having same atomic number are isotopes, and helium is not. So isotopes are the elements of same number of protons or atomic number. For example, hydrogen and deuterium having same atomic number but different mass number. Then isotopes of uranium having mass number 234, 235 and 238 and atomic number 92. So in uranium, 238, 235, 234, atomic number is 92, same. So these three are isotopes of each other, and mixture of these three is called as natural uranium. So in most of the power plant, fuel uses natural uranium. Chemical reaction and nuclear reaction. We have hydrogen and deuterium. When combined with oxygen, oxidation takes place and form a product of combustion. Hydrogen combined with oxygen form a water. Deuterium combined with oxygen form a deuterium oxide, heavy water. So in chemical reaction, the nucleus of the element remains same and the atom structure will not change. In a nuclear reaction, the nucleus breaks and another nuclei are formed, and the atomic number, mass number also changes, which are not changing in chemical reactions. In chemical reaction, heat will be absorbed or heat will be released. In combustion, heat is released. in nuclear reaction, in splitting of nuclei, heat is released. In combining of nuclei, also heat is released. And during nuclear reaction, huge amount of energy is released, which is used in power plant to generate steam. In atom, along with proton, neutron, electron, there are positron and neutron also present. Positron are positively charged electron, and neutron are tiny electrically neutral emitted in emissions. Nuclear fission is the process used in a nuclear reactor to generate energy. In nuclear fission, slow or medium speed or high speed neutron is bombarded on a heavy nucleus to split the nucleus into lighter nuclei, and the huge amount of energy is released. So splitting of heavy nucleus by bombarding high energy particle is called as nuclear fission. This schematic shows high speed neutron is bombarding on uranium nucleus, and uranium nucleus split into two nuclei, xenon nucleus and strontium nucleus, and keeping two neutron free for the next reaction. So this is the schematic of the nuclear reaction, and nuclear reaction can be written in this way. Uranium 235 is bombarded by a high energy particle neutron, then uranium split into germanium and strontium and release huge energy and two neutron. This shows chain reaction for fission of uranium. And in a fission reaction, from parent nuclei, another nuclei are formed, and that is called as fission fragment. So in fission of uranium nucleus, xenon and strontium is formed, are called as fission fragments. And in fission reaction, the energy release delta E is given by delta M into C square, where delta M is called as mass defect and C is the speed of light, which is 3 lakh kilometer per second. And delta M is the mass defect, which is the difference in mass of atom and mass of sum of mass of each particle, that is sum of mass of proton, neutron, electron. Typically, the sum of mass of proton, neutron, electron is more than the mass of atom, and that difference is called as mass defect. And the energy release in the fission process, delta E is mass defect into square of speed light. And this mass defect keep the neutron and proton together, and so this delta E is also called as binding energy, which act as a glue for maintaining nucleus to keep the proton and neutrons together. And when this nucleus breaks, this much amount of energy is released. delta E equal to delta M C square, where delta M is a mass defect and C is the speed of light. Another process in a nuclear reaction is nuclear fusion. In this case, two lighter nucleus combine together and form a heavier and stable nuclei. Means by combining two lighter nuclei, heavier nucleus is formed, and during that the energy is released, which is equal to delta E into delta M C square, where delta M is the mass difference of mass of atom and mass of two nuclei. Mass of two nuclei is more than the resultant nucleus, and that difference is called as delta M. And the energy released during combining of nuclei is delta E equal to delta M C square. And to bring the lighter nuclei together for fusion, temperature required is very high, and it is required in the range of 10^9 degrees Celsius. Radioactivity, which is the important property of heavier nuclear elements, and few naturally occurring heavier elements with isotopes are unstable and undergo series of disintegration and emit radiations till more stable nucleus is formed. Example is natural uranium. This process in which the heavy nucleus disintegrate to form a different nuclei is called as radioactivity, and the elements are called as radioactive elements. And during this process of decay, various radiations are emitted, like alpha, beta, gamma, which are very harmful to the human being and plants. And radioactivity is the source for energy, and the time taken by series of disintegration of active element to form a stable element is called as radioactive decay. And the radioactive decay varies element wise. The rate of decay is does not depend upon pressure, temperature, volume, and it only depends upon the number of nuclei. If n is the number of radioactive nuclei of any one species at any time t, then the decay rate is directly proportional to number of nuclei n. Mathematically, the decay rate is given by this expression, minus dn by dt equal to lambda into n, where lambda is decay constant. By integrating this equation, we are getting the equation n, number of nuclei at time t, equal to the number of nuclei at time equal to 0 into e raised to minus lambda into t. So this equation gives the number of nuclei present at time t, okay, if the initial nuclei are known. The radioactive nature of different isotope is measured by a time known as half time. or half-time life. And the rate of decay, minus dn by dt, is also called as activity. And when time is taken half, okay, and the number of nuclei initial become half, means when the ratio n upon n naught is half, then time is half time, half lifetime, t by 2. And the equation for the half life of any element is given by t equal to 0.693 upon lambda. So half life is defined as the time taken by a particular element to disintegrate its nuclei by half. Thank you. In next unit, we'll discuss the elements of power plants and elements of nuclear reactor and types of nuclear reactor.